heights to a team like Air Force has made, or the Falcons aren't exactly skyscrapers either. Smoky Games relied heavily on a two-point guard offense, paid off with a 69-50 victory. Anthony Watson, high point man, with 16. Solid all-around night, too, for Creon Dorsey. Dorsey's deadly from 20 feet. The Aztecs' four-point guard combination, Watson, Dorsey, Dildy, and Owens, accounted for 51 of the 69 points.
I was trying to use the quickness, and Creon was hitting decent, so we felt that by us moving the ball, we had Creon in, you know, he was 4-for-6 the first half. We wanted him outside shooting after Josh got hurt. We just decided to go with the two-point guard.
USC Toreros made it a cross-town sweep. They knocked off Montana State 77-63. USC put this one away early, building up a 20-point lead at the halftime. Peter Murphy led the Toreros with 14, most of them from long range, but Mr. Murphy was pretty fair and close, too. Big center Scott Thompson played one of his better games. He had 13. USC is now 8-4. They host Captain Mike's school, St. Ambrose, on Saturday.
Welcome back to Altech Sports Draft. This has been a winning weekend for college basketball teams in San Diego, especially for the San Diego State Aztecs. After a horrible 1-9 preseason, the Aztecs are 2-0 in the West, and this is when it counts. Last night to beat Colorado State 72-56. Not bad for a young team with no size that has been decimated by injury. Al Janis has more.
Young teams are supposed to come unglued down the stretch, but maybe Smoky Gaines has finally found the right combination, because the Aztecs are starting to put together some good second halves, and it's paid off with wins in their first two conference games. Last night against Colorado State, they bounced back from shooting only 33% in the first half to hit 56% over the final 20 minutes. And even better, they popped in 18 of 20 free throws the second half. That's a red-hot 90%. The other guys get behind and they keep fouling you, and you keep hitting those charity shots, they're not going to catch you. And because of injuries to all their big men, the Aztecs will probably get out-rebounded every night. And the Rams did pull down 17 more boards than San Diego did. Their big guy, 6'9", Rich Strong, a second-team all-WAC performer, pulled down 11 himself and scored 17 points, right at his average. But the Aztecs more than overcame his output with a hustling defense. That caused the Rams to make 8 more turnovers than San Diego did. And the Aztecs had 4 players in double figures. Anthony Watson, the leader again. Anthony's had 2 straight 16-point games since Smokey sat him down for one game. Creon Dorsey had 14 and a whole bunch of steals. And you spread it around like this, you don't have to worry as much when somebody gets cold. 12 for Bobby Owens, and they got another 14 from a new source from right here in San Diego. Out of Patrick Henry High, Daryl Gaines, the coach's son. And listen to this, Daryl was a perfect 4-for-4 from the field, a perfect 6-for-6 from the line. He also pulled down 5 rebounds. Hey, Daryl, where you been hiding?
Well, being 0-7, you know, your confidence is going to be down. But see, we're winning some games now, and we're feeling we can win. We know we can win now, so our confidence is increasing.
We just decided we're going to go out and have some fun, you know, really. And, you know, with the tremendous boost that we got from Dr. Miller, that helped a lot of too. You know, he came in and talked to guys and said, hey, we for you guys 100%. So just go out and see what you can establish for this season and go from there. Let's build a program here.
We just have come together, you know, these last two games, because we really have been playing a lot of tough competition in the early part of the season.
Now they got to go on the road to play BYU and Utah. But you know what? Both the Cougars and Utes lost last night. Maybe these first two won't be the only wins for the Aztecs. From the sports arena, Al Janis for Sports Wrap.
8 checks a swing for strike 2, and Gossage moves ahead. Whitfield is a pinch hitter, is 4%. A ball and 2 strikes. Let me try it again with a ball and 2 strikes. Here's the 1-2 pitch. And he got him, and the Padres come up with an unlikely victory over Fernando Valenzuela. Final score on your Hagen Chevrolet scorecard. Padres 1, the Dodgers nothing. For the San Diego Padres here at Dodger Stadium, Fernando Valenzuela had the meeting out of his hand all game long. He struck out 10. He looked outstanding, had given up only one base hit. And then with one down in the ninth inning, here comes Tony Gwynn, who rocked one over the right field wall to put the Padres on the board. The Goose came in to pick up his 5th save. And I got to tell you, it is something. Craig Leppard gets a win. He is 1-0. And in a day when it looked like it was all Fernando all the way, the Padres came back to pick it up. They had a big chance, as you know, in the second inning with the bases loaded. and couldn't get a run across. The Dodgers had two chances. One with the bases loaded, nobody out, couldn't get a run in. And one with the bases loaded and two out and couldn't get a run across. And now Dave Campbell standing by in the field with our special guest. David, it's all yours.
Thank you, Jerry. Tony Gwynn, championship baseball is what it's all about, isn't it?
Yes, it is. You know, this week's been a tough week for us, I think. And coming in here and losing the first two and then winning last night's game, this was a big win for us because we were playing kind of flat. And I'm just happy we can get out of here with a split.
Tony, I mentioned on the air watching the replay, it looked like you cranked your bat up about the time Fernando wound up. And I know you usually don't swing for home runs, but I actually thought you were swinging for a home run there.
Yeah, well, the last time up, I was going to give it one shot. And I had one other pitch early in the game, and it was the first pitch that he threw me in the first inning with a fastball inside. And he'd been throwing me sliders the rest of the day. And I thought, you know, usually in that situation, I'm taking a strike. So I figured maybe he'll pump the fastball inside and hopefully I can hit it out. And that's what happened. And it doesn't happen very often, but I'm kind of glad it happened today.
Well, you know, home run hitters strike out a lot. Now, what's the deal? You go 70 times without striking out. You go your last time last night, first time tonight. But I guess against those two pitches that they made on you, it's no disgrace.
Yeah, well, you know, last night Castillo threw me a screwball. And that's one of the few times I've seen a screwball from the right side. And you know, Fernando was tough all day today. The pitch I struck out on was a perfect slider on the outside corner, and I was looking for something in the middle part of the plate in, and I struck out. And, you know, I don't like to strike out, but, you know, when a game turns out the way it did today, I don't mind.
You know, I mentioned earlier the mental aspect of baseball. When you see a guy like a Hershiser and Fernando and what a great groove they're in, how tough it is to stay mentally tough as a ball club. But I think the Padres really did that today.
Yeah, well, I think that's, you know, that's kind of like the trademark of our ball club, because even when things don't look like they're going to go our way, we still keep hanging in there and keep battling, keep plugging, and hopefully we'll get a break. And last night, Kurt helped us out a lot with that pinch hit double. And then today was my turn. And when you're gonna have a winning baseball team, you gotta have guys who can pick you up when you're down. And I think that's part of our team. You know, everybody's in there to try to help pick us up when we're down.
Looks to me like Goose is throwing awfully good in the early going this year.
Yeah, well, I think Goose is happy this year that he's getting a chance to get in there and get some innings in, because last year I think he started off well, but then in the middle he didn't have many opportunities to get out there and pitch. And he likes that situation where he can go in and pitch an inning and hopefully get a save. And it's happened a lot early, and hopefully it'll happen the rest of the season.
Okay, everybody in the National League, especially the pitchers, know Tony Gwynn.
Last week they lost to the worst team in the WAC, Hawaii. Tonight they beat the number one team, Wyoming, 88-82. In the process, the Aztecs go to 5-3 in league, and that's good for second place. Now, there were times when the Aztecs made Wyoming look awfully good. Look at Les Bolden here, all alone. He had 18 points, but the Aztecs call on Anthony Watson for a second game in a row. He breaks a 30-point barrier. Watson with the finger roll, he had 30 points for the ball game. Another big night for the big man, Stephon Johnson. The rebounded score here, he had 22 points. Now, here are a couple of the young guys. Tracy Dildy, the pass to Keith Brown, and the Aztecs lead by 2 at halftime. But Wyoming takes over second half. Eric Lechner with 28, and the Cowboys have a 5-point lead with 2 minutes to play. But here come the Aztecs. They outscore Wyoming 13-1 in the final 2 minutes. Johnson ties it at 81, and Bobby Owens with the perfect steal right here. He takes it in for the score. The Aztecs rallied to beat Wyoming 88-82. Owens with the play of the game.
Couldn't get it clicking in the first half. In the second half, I made a promise to myself that if I go in there, you know, I'm going to play hard. And that's what I did. I played hard. I got a couple of key steals, made some free throws, layups.
Much for that season to start. After a fast start in the WAC, Aztecs is going to come back to earth with a thud. BYU beat them tonight, 81-71. San Diego State now just over 500 in the conference with a 6-5 mark. Another big night for Anthony Watson. For a while, it looked like his hot hand might be enough for the Aztecs. Watson, 25 points in the first half, 32 for the night. Four of the last five games now, he's had 30-plus. John Martin's a good power move here in a crowd, had 10 points and 10 rebounds. Aztecs led by 5.5. BYU wore him down after intermission. Cougars got hot. Aztecs cooled off, hit only 31% of the shots. San Diego Bob Kaitner led BYU. He had 22 in top 10.